Okay, so we had a question regarding the, can the back fist be done on the chest and the ribs? And the answer is wholeheartedly yes. So it depends on your goal and what you're actually looking to do as far as your self-defense scenario. But a lot of the times, everybody's working to hit the head. So you'll see people that are working regardless of the height of the opponent. If it's somebody taller, the other person will try to get over their arms and really off-balance themselves to try to actually make that work, and it doesn't work well. You got to use your own height. So the thing is here, if he's throwing this punch like that and I'm on this side, we'll just kind of use like a Rebel Wing Chun deflections and that sort of thing, is that if I do the Lop Sao and I do this strike here, back fist can come in directly right there, and that's more of a liver shot, which is really excellent. If I come in like this and I do a parry lop and I hit it here, that's more of the rib, and believe me, you will feel that on the rib. So again, this is the top line doesn't really matter. There's so many different ways that you can deflect or work. And it's just, even if sort of he just throws it, I'm just coming in through here. And then I just work towards hitting. All I'm gonna do is just put that, just double arm block, crash on in, and then work the back fist nicely to the ribs. So that's if I'm on the inside, it's easier to hit the ribs because of the articulation of the joint. So whack, whack. If I'm on the outside, the Lop Sao helps me pull in. So I can hit here, or I can hit here onto the chest. So if he puts it up on the chest, that works just as well too. And there are times where you may not want, you know, to hit the jawline or to try to bury teeth in your knuckles and that sort of thing. You may not wish to. It works really well. Again, on the outside, you want to work to here. You can get to the solar plexus. You can get to the liver shot. You can work to the spleen, depending on how far over you are. If I'm on this side of the body and he's throwing with this punch and I get to here, now we're working towards the spleen, working towards the solar plexus, and I can work up towards the chest plate itself. That is for grinding, works really well. You can hit people here in the chest a lot and they can take quite a bit. The articulation of the joint here helps determine where you go. For me to hit over here onto this side is gonna be a little harder to do. Over here it's much easier, so I can pop those ribs nicely. Same thing here along this line, chest, solar plexus, and down at the rib cage. So anything that you're using, so he's throwing that strike, if I'm going up through here, this Lop Sao, and then I pop that into play, to help make that work, I pull so that he's off balance, so that my next shot works just as well. Throws the punch like this, Lop Sao, pulls it in, and then feeds the other punch on top. So once more, we'll look at it from this side. Throws that punch, Lop Sao. So we're doing this Bong Sao. So as it comes in like that, Bong Sao deflection, Lop Sao, back fist strike. If I wanted to hit the ribs, it's easier if I do parry, Lop Sao, and then strike here. So typically he'll have that hand up. So if he's like in boxing mode and he fires that, we're looking at a 1-2, right? So that's where my back fist will go there. So if he fires a jab cross, yep. We'll switch leads for a second, just so I make more sense. There we go. So we fire a jab cross again, bam, bam. That's what we're looking at. So jab, cross. So jab, right there. My moving forward helps make that happen, because I'll do two things. One, I will make it a shorter distance for me to hit him, and two, I will start to jam his punch with the other hand. If I stay out here like this, because I'm afraid of getting hit, he will most likely get that shot off, and then he'll interfere, and then I've got to work another Bong Sao, I've got to do something else in order to make that work. If you're doing this deflection, you're hitting like that, come on in, it's going to change his perspective. Off of this, I can hit the ribs. Somebody getting hit in the ribs as they're trying to punch, you really gotta experience it. It's one of those things that makes you forget about your next shot. Especially in this particular case, if I do this parry and I hit right here, this is really sensitive. It's the same thing here. If I'm on the inside and you hit those tender ribs like that, I'm telling you, it's a huge impact. You got to try it. Even with just boxing gloves on, have your friend pop you carefully and so forth so you get an idea. Or hit yourself there so you get an idea of what that's like, and then work it to the back fist a little bit. But hopefully that answers your question. You can definitely do it. It's just a matter of making sure that you come in on the shot so that you interfere with their continued success on their strikes. But you're also working for the inside. The rib shots work better. The outside, solar plexus and center of the chest, and of course, the jawline and throat.